decided to record this CD, I just knew that I wanted to make a special program, like not just two pieces or one cycle of pieces, because that I can still always do in a second one or a third one. But the first one, I think, is also an impression of myself and who I am and my character and the way I want to present classical music towards an audience. So I figured that it's very much more interesting for me and for the audience to record a lot of different pieces. So I started with a sonata by Clementi, which is one of my favorite sonatas by him. I know it because I heard a recording of Horowitz playing this sonata, and it felt like I have to start my CD with this piece. It's just like perfect. You can listen to it, it's very open, it's like very airy, you can just like breathe in and out and just listen to it. It doesn't have anything like difficult or stressy to listen to, it's just very relaxed. And then I figured I should go to Chopin Dante's Pianato, Grande Polonaise Brilliante. It's a huge title for this piece. But yeah, it's an amazing piece. It's one of the last Polonaise I think Chopin ever composed. And normally it's for piano and orchestra, but this is a solo version. So I figured it's nice. First you have something classical, then you have something romantic. That's actually still standard for a CD recording. But then I figured I should take Prokofiev as a contrast between those two, which is also still an early sonata, so it remains very romantic. But I think it's a great piece in the middle of the piece. So actually it's the biggest piece in the whole recording. It's four movements, it's the most imposant. It's like very much more not so easy to listen to. So afterwards I thought I should remain in the same energy, like it's very energetic, and then go to a South American composer, Ginastera, who composed the three Danzas Argentinas. And I think it's an amazing piece, and it's very close to who I am as a person. It's like this typical South American temperament. I don't know, I'm not South American, but I feel like I have something of this in me. So I felt I should just like let go of all my energy and just like play my heart out. And then afterwards, because I love jazz, but I can't improvise yet, I still wanted to finish with something which is totally different than the rest on the CD. And I figured I should do it with Kapustin, because I played this piece for quite a long time, and I actually like it so much, and I feel that every time I play a recital and I end with this piece, or I play an encore and I play this, that people just really like it, because it's something they won't never expect. And for me, in classical music, everything's so neat and organized, and we're always with the black and white bow tie and everything. And for me, it feels like I just want to do new things. It shouldn't always be that correct and thematically like interesting. And that's why I figured that I shouldn't find one theme in the city, but that I just like take pieces which I feel that are very organic between entre les deux, like between the two, but that it's still like very renewing, that it's not just like, oh, I buy a CD with all the etudes by list, and then I just listen to all the etudes by list and it's great, played, the music is great. But I don't know, I like the idea of that when you put a CD on, you're home alone, you're just sitting on your couch, you want to enjoy some music, that you can just have the feeling that you're in a concert without being there, and that you hear different things, that you experience also different things, but it still feels at one, like as one. There are so many composers who are famous, and there's so many pieces written for the instrument that it's just impossible to play everything. And I have this little book where I write all the pieces down that I actually want to play in my life. But the list is endless long. And it's like a kind of bucket list, exactly, because you hear so many pieces. And every time I say, oh, yes, this I still need to play, or this is still very interesting. And then I figure, but yeah, maybe I should just write it down. And then when the moment comes and I have to learn something new, that I have the choice of the pieces that I already like. So I don't have an aim to play all the pieces by Ravel, for example. But I already played quite some pieces from Ravel. But just by coincidence then, because I figured, oh, that would be nice with this and this and this. And I like to combine the programs, always with something new and something special, that people still have the feeling that they have so many different things to listen to without being overwhelmed, that there's still kind of a line in it without really seeing that in the program, but when you listen to it. And I think that's also the most important thing. People come to listen, of course, to see, but the most important thing is to listen to just, like, I don't know, let go of all the things you're thinking about and just, like, enjoy without using words, because that's, I think, something very unique. I mean, we just push down some keys on an instrument and, like, something just magical happens without you being able to explain in words what you just felt or experienced, or, I don't know. And not everybody probably needs it, but without you knowing it, music is everywhere. And we are so used to it, and it's something so... Yeah, it became something so natural also to, like, sing around when you're happy, or, I don't know, when you feel sad, you will listen to something down to just cry your heart out, and then afterwards you feel better. And why is that with music? I think that's an interesting question.